Hello everyone, today let's see chapter 2, capital structure. Let's see the meaning. What is capital structure? Capital structure means it is a permanent finance of the firm. Weston and Brigham define capital structure as the permanent financing of the firm represented by long-term debt, preferred stock and net worth. So capital structure means it is the permanent finance of the firm and it represents a long-term debt. Long-term debt includes debenture, bonds and long-term loans. And preferred stock means preference shares. So net worth includes equity shares and reserves and surplus. So all together is called capital structure of the companies. Fixed assets of an organization are funded through such sources which have longer period of repayment. Long-term debt like debenture, it is payable after 5 years. In case of long-term loans, it can be extended up to 10 to 15 years. Then preference shares that can have a tenure of even 10 years. And net worth. The net worth includes equity and reserves. Equity means equity shares and reserves. They have a permanent existence and that need not to be repaid. So there is no repayment for equity shareholders or for equity. So there is important task for the finance manager, that is to determine how much should be the debt and how much should be the equity in capital structure of a company. Because if any wrong measure is made in capital structure, that will have a long lasting impact throughout the life of the company. Because when company is newly started, that time if company is having a huge size of debt, that time company's profit definitely it will be not as expected, it will be low and or there may be no profit. But for the debt holders, payment of interest is compulsory. If company fails to pay the interest, then lender, they can file a case against the company and take action against the company. Or in case of secured loans, where company's assets is given as a security, so they can take over the assets. So any wrong measure or decision with regard to the capital structure component which is made by the finance manager, if it is wrong, then it will have a long lasting impact on the company's life. Now let's see the first component, that is debt. Any source of finance that gives creditorship status to the supplier of funds is called debt. Here creditorship status means the provider of funds has a right to receive interest at an agreed rate. So here the creditorship means the provider of the fund is having a right to receive a fixed rate of interest, and if that interest is not paid or if company fails to pay the interest, then that provider of fund can take a legal action against the company as per the lending agreement. In case of debt, there is compulsory payment of interest irrespective of the profit earned by the company. Company has to pay fixed rate of interest and that is compulsorily payable. There is reduced tax liability for the company if it has debt in its capital structure. This is because interest is deducted from the taxable income before calculating the tax liability. So, amount or profit on which company is going to or pay as a tax, that reduces when company has more debt in its capital structure. Debt is the sum of two items on the liability side of a company's balance sheet, that is a secured loan and unsecured loan. Secured loan requires creation of a charge on the specific assets in favor of the lender. Without repaying the secured debt, the company cannot sell its assets on which a mortgage is created. So, yawa assets anna security agi ittirtare for the loan taken, aa assets anna loan repay madade sell madlikke agudilla. That's a thing here in case of secured loans. Unsecured loans where any charge is not created on any assets. So generally, the debt of a company has three components, that is bonds, debentures and long-term loans. Companies, they'll prefer debt in order to avoid hostile takeover. Hostile takeover means you know what is taking over of company, where another company by paying some certain amount it takes over the other company. So here hostile takeover means here competing firm, they'll purchase the equity shares of a company by having voting rights. They are trying to have a control over the managerial aspects of the business. So that way they are going to have a control over the business. So that's what hostile takeover means. By purchasing the shares, especially equity shares, which carries voting rights, by purchasing those kind of shares, competing firms, they'll try to have a control over the management of the company. So that's why, to avoid that, companies, they prefer debt securities in their capital structure. This is because a debt holder will not have any voting right. Let's see the features of debt. First feature is compulsory payment of interest. As per the borrowing agreement, interest is payable periodically, and failure to do so will give the lender the right to file a case in a court. So, as per the borrowing agreement, interest payment is compulsory for all the companies, and if they fail to pay the interest, then lender can take a legal action by filing a case in a court of law, that is for the recovery of interest. And again, they may call for the liquidation of the company. Compulsory repayment. When debt becomes due, the principal should be repaid as per the agreement. In case of a debenture, principal is payable on maturity, but interest should be payable annually. Every year interest should be payable. In case of bonds, principal as well as interest, it is paid at the end. That means at on maturity. In case of long-term loans, principal plus interest, both it is paid in installments. So here also, company has borrowed loan through secured loans. Secured loans means on the assets of the company, charge is created. When charge is created on the assets of the company, failure to pay the debt amount, failure to repay the debt amount will lead to taking over of the assets of the company. Only fixed interest. The lenders do not have any claim on the profits of the company under any circumstances. Because the very creditorship status that deprives them from demanding on the surplus profit. So only equity shareholders, they will be having a right to take part in the surplus profits of the company. So lenders, they do not have any right to ask for the surplus profits of the company. So they are eligible to get only fixed interest rate and not more than that. No claim for receiving annual reports. Investors in debt securities are not entitled to receive annual reports of the company. Again, they are not eligible to receive notice of general body meeting. Only big lenders like term lending institutions, they put a condition in the lending agreement so that they can get notices as well as reports of annual general meeting. No voting rights. Lenders, they do not have voting rights except in the cases where resolution is passed in their interest, or resolution is passed that is relating to the debenture holders. So other than that, only their representatives can participate and vote at the meeting, and not a debenture holder or a bond holder can participate in the annual general meeting in his capacity as an individual investor. So debenture holder or debt holder as an individual investor, he cannot vote and participate in the annual general meeting. Only the representative of debenture holders can vote, or they can participate in the annual general meeting. Next, let's see the merits of debt. First merit is benefit of leverage. Benefit of leverage. Leverage means here the presence of debt on the capital structure increases the earning per share so that it benefits the equity shareholders. So that's what benefit of leverage means. While solving the problem, you'll be getting to know by having debt how these equity shareholders are going to benefit. So how they are getting more EPS for their shareholdings. So benefit of leverage is, leverage means by having debt in a capital structure, equity shareholders are benefiting through the increased EPS. This is because when you have more debt in a capital structure, so where number of equity shareholders, that is very less because we have debt. So that number of equity shareholders are less, because of that they are getting good EPS or increased rate of EPS, earning per share. But when company has only equity in its capital structure, so that entire profit is distributed among the investors, that means equity shareholders. So where one equity shareholder is getting less, so because of that number of shareholders reduces in case if the company is having a debt in its capital structure. Tax advantages. As taxable income is calculated after deducting interest on debt, so it reduces the tax liability of the company. So that's what company gets a tax advantage. Taxable income is calculated on the profit after deducting interest on debt from that, so that tax liability is less in case of companies which is having a debt. Cost of raising funds compared to equity shares, where cost of issue that is less compared to the equity shareholders. So in case of debt, cost of raising funds is less. And again, here in case of long-term loans, they need to just prepare a project report and submit to the financial institution. Company need to prepare project report, and that is not a big issue. And they need to have a stamp, they need to pay stamp duty on that. So that's only the expenses they are incurring in case of raising of funds through debt. But in case of equity, their various financial intermediaries, so they need to appoint like bankers, brokers, advertising agencies. So all those financial intermediaries, they need to appoint registrar. So for that purpose, they need to pay commission to them so that cost of raising equity shares, funds through equity shares, are very high compared to debt. Then managerial stability. As debt securities do not carry voting rights, any takeover attempt by the other company, debenture holders
do not pose any threat to the management. So they do not have any voting rights. Equity shareholders are called as owners of the company. So they are having voting rights. By exercising their voting power, they can have control over the management of the company. They can stop or they can object for any important decisions taken by the company. But in case of company which is having debt only in its capital structure, which will not face managerial instability. That means they do not have any problem from the debt holders for their management. Easier SEBI norms. SEBI norms regarding issue of securities and investors protection are very strict in case of equity shares. But the scope of protecting the right of lenders is very limited. So, companies, they need to follow the SEBI regulations in order to protect the interest of investors, especially who are investing in a shares of a company. But if a company is taking fund through the debt, then there will be no such strict rules for the protection of interest of lenders. Flexible features. Debt can have a feature regarding payment of interest, rate of interest, period of repayment, etc. So different features can be added for a same security, like a multiple option bond. I have already explained what is multiple option bond. So that is a good example of this. In case of long-term loans, you can negotiate the term. Finance manager, he can make changes in the terms of the loans. You can make changes in interest rate, repayment period. So features can be changed, or terms of lending agreement that can be changed through negotiation with the funding agencies. So that's why these debt securities will be having flexible features. Stable market force securities. For debt securities, market is stable. Timing of issuing debt securities is not difficult as in case of equity shares. While raising funds through debt, company need not to watch the mood of environment or mood of the market. But in case of equity shares, they need to study whether there is a suitable mood in the stock market. Because in the year 2007, DLF Limited, 3 times they postponed the issue of shares. That means 3 times they have postponed the date of issue of shares. Because if there is no demand for the shares which is being issued now, then it will have a bad impact on the company. It will affect the goodwill of the company. And again, company need to spend a lot of money while issuing shares. So it will incur certain expense, that is cost of issue. That will become waste if it will not get required amount from the investor. So that's why they have to see whether there is a suitable mood in the stock market when it goes for issuing shares through initial public offer. First time it is issuing a shares to public. Managerial administration expenses. Debt securities are not frequently purchased and sold like equity shares. So company incurs less expenses for transferring debt securities among investors. So equity shares are transferable from one person to another person. We can transfer equity share, but in case of debt securities, not like that. It is transferred or it is returned back to the company at the time of maturity, or when company wants it back, that time lender can return it to the company. Before that, a lender cannot ask for the principal amount. So there is managerial administration expenses that is very less in case of debt. So transfer expenses, the cost of transfer, that is not there in case of debt, because it is not frequently purchased and sold like equity shares. Flexible repayment. On the issue of debt securities, company puts a clause. Clause means condition that may be repaid even before the date of maturity. So company can put a condition that it can repay even before the maturity date. So when it has surplus cash, that cash it can use for the purpose of repaying it debt. But in case of equity, it cannot do so, because equity shares, it is a permanent capital of the company. It cannot be repaid. Only by passing a resolution, it can buy back its shares in order to reduce the size of capital. But in case of debt, whenever it has money, it can repay the debt. That is possible only when it has put a condition in the lending agreement. Yes, in case of long-term loan, companies can prepay the loans. Easier regulatory compliance. So there are many regulatory agents for capital market. For the shares, there are many regulatory agents regulatory compliance is less in case of debt securities. In case of shares, the regulatories are SEBI. They need to follow the requirements of SEBI, Stock Exchange Authority, Ministry of Finance. All their proceedings must be followed by the companies. All the rules and regulations that should be followed by the company. But in case of debt, regulatory compliance, following the rules and regulations of all those regulatories, are very less in case of debt securities, because there is a concept of corporate governance, that is protection of stakeholders, but their importance is given to the protection of shareholders rather than debt holders. So corporate fines means companies, they find the regulatory agencies are not very strict in case of debt, as lenders have nothing to do with the profit. Then demerits of debt. Compulsory payment of interest. Interest is payable compulsorily even in the event of loss. In such a case, it only adds to the losses incurred. So already company is earning a loss from very many years. Now again it has to pay interest, means it adding to the losses only. There were many instances where companies raised the debt during initial period, so that they suffered a continuous losses because of interest payment in the subsequent years. So company should avoid debt during gestation period. Gestation period means it has just started. Company has just started its business, or it is new company. So any subsequent borrowing should be repaid at the earliest occasion. So debt adds to the risk of an industrial unit. Solvency affected. Non-payment of dividend is not a serious threat to the existence of the company. But non-payment of interest that may lead to liquidation of the company through lawsuits. When they fail to pay the interest, that time lender can file a case against the company, so that company may go to liquidation. So there are many companies that have converted its debt into equity in order to avoid the liquidations, so that when debt is converted into equity in case of equity, dividend payment is not compulsory. Compulsory redemption. As per the terms of borrowing, debt should be redeemed at the predetermined date, but such a predetermined date may not be very, sorry, it may turn out to be very uncomfortable date to the company in terms of its cash position. We don't know what may happen in future. So in future date, when date of payment comes, that company may not be in a position to repay that. So if fail to repay that amount on debt, then that debt holder can take over the assets of the company. So that is the main demerit of this debt securities. Charge on assets. A charge in the form of mortgage on the physical assets of the company may have to be created in favor of lenders. So this may create a problem for the company when it goes for selling of its asset. When charge is created on a specific asset, that asset cannot be sold to another company or any other person when charge is created. So charge created on assets creates a problem when company wants to sell that particular asset. Credit rate shopping. As per SEBI regulation, every debt securities like or debentures should be rated by a credit rating agency like CRISIL, ICRA or CARK. Apart from the process being tedious and expensive, there is a risk of the agency that may downgrade the rating of the security subsequently. So that may give a less rate to the company's debt security. So this is about debt securities. Then about equity shares, or about equity, we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.